scores as Connecticut plays its final home game of the regular season, looking to burst Villanova's bubble. The Wildcats hope to augment their resume by doing something they've done only once, and that's win at Campbell Pavilion. Villanova 7-7 in the league. 8 losses for them on the season have come against teams with 20 wins or more. Their final game is Saturday against Syracuse. Connecticut 6-8 in the standings. Last time they had 8 losses in the league, they went to the NIT back in 2001. I'm Dave Pasch alongside Coach Rick Majerus. Let's talk Villanova, Coach. Everybody wants to know where the Wildcats stand as of today. What do they have to do in their last 2 games to secure an NCAA tournament berth?
They've got to win 1 of 2 to get to the 500 mark in order to add that exclamation point to the NCAA berth. UConn, meanwhile, this is a statement game about where they're going to go next year, but they can't win the lottery without winning the playoff game tonight to get there. It's big for them, too, if they have any NCAA aspirations.
And both teams have a guard playing particularly well. Jerome Dyson for the Huskies, Scotty Reynolds for the Wildcats.
Reynolds has to bring his swagger, all of his scoring capabilities, and a defensive commitment tonight. Jerome Dyson has to give us his A game as a scorer, and he's going to have to also belly up to the bar as a defender in order for his team to win as well.
Taking a look at the rest of the lineups for Villanova, Reynolds, Nardi, Cunningham, Sheridan, and Curtis Sumter, who's third in the conference in scoring for UConn, Dyson, Price, Johnson, Adrian, and Hashim Fabit, the third leading shot blocker in the country. Tonight's game available in high definition on ESPN HD. A sold-out Campbell Pavilion. Connecticut, start of the year 11-0, was ranked as high as number 8. Villanova, as mentioned, 8 of its 9 losses against teams with at least 20 wins. And Jay Wright is hoping to lead the Wildcats to their third straight NCAA tournament, coming off a school record 28 victories. He's done a great job with this team after losing all those great players like Foy to the NBA. Jim Calhoun, certainly a challenging year for a longtime Husky coach, playing without a scholarship senior and without a scholarship junior. Talk about talent. Connecticut lost its best 6 players off that team from a year ago that went to the Final 8.
Both these teams want to get the ball out in the open court, and neither team has an inside scoring presence. How they handle the pick and roll tonight and how they execute it is going to be a determinant factor to the outcome of this game.
Here's Dyson, has been red hot, 20 points per game over his last 5. He misses his first shot, and Sumter, averaging 7 boards a game, pulls it down. Reynolds able to hit Cunningham in the lane, and Fabit got a piece of it. It will stay Villanova basketball.
Louisville had well over 50 points in the paint. So many of them came in conversion. They're going to have to stop the ball and get back and transition D.
Here's Nardi for 3, and that's a great sign for Villanova. Only 8 points per game for Nardi over his last 3, and he's been struggling with his shot, but he buries that one.
Historically, how he starts is how he finishes. Not a good omen there for the Huskies.
Good job, Mike!
Villanova ended a 2-game losing streak with a win over Rutgers. A lot of people think right now that the Wildcats are in, but in talking with Jay Wright today, he says he won't feel comfortable until they get to the Big East tournament at 9-7 in the league, as the beat taps it home for UConn's first basket.
Well, here's one of many hands that made a stab on the ball and got the fortuitous bounce.
He's also got the biggest hands and longest arms to get to that ball.
And incredibly a short stride. He doesn't have a long stride for a big guy.
Scotty Reynolds for 3. Perhaps the Big East Rookie of the Year. Reynolds, the 4th leading scorer in conference games.
Showing the serious confidence he has in himself right there.
Dyson took it away from Nardi, then he lost it. Jump ball, it will go to Villanova on the alternate possession. How about the play of Scotty Reynolds, Coach, over the last 10 games?
Last week at practice, he was green-lighted, and Coach Wright was imploring him to score, and look to score some more.
He's shooting over 60% from 3 over his last 3-plus games. 23 points per game during that span.
He's really emerged, too, in terms of his psychological outlook to the game.
I think at first he was deferring a lot when he came in to Nardi.
And credit Nardi with subordinating himself to this young Scotty's advancement.
Nice block by Johnson. Another jump ball, and it goes to UConn. Let's take a look at Villanova's resume. Excellent schedule strength. And the controversial RPI is good.
Well, they got the Joel Lunardi numbers game one, our expert ESPN bracketologist. But still, if they were to lose these last two, this one in Syracuse at the Wachovia Center, the red hot Orangemen, it would be hard at a 7-9 record.
Lunardi today has 8 Big East teams in, and that's how many made it a year ago.
I wouldn't bet against Joel Lunardi. I'm going to tell you that right now. I hope our scientists out there trying to cure cancer are as committed.
Price working on Sumter will shoot over him. And rebounded by Sheridan out to Reynolds. Villanova looking to run. Reynolds driving hard to the goal. And nice job by Johnson to save it for the Huskies.
Now speed kills, and he sped that up when he didn't have to.
Dyson a deep three. He knew it was off right when he released it. Rebounded by Sheridan.
Catch up, Rome!
Or to be young to be Reynolds or Dyson and have that green light.
Both Villanova's baskets, threes, one by Nardi, one by Reynolds. Cunningham double teamed. Reynolds looks for his second three, brick that one. Pulled down by Johnson. Here's Price.
Kelly, the New York City Player of the Year, did a good job of coming out and helping out. It was his hand that got up to Reynolds that enabled him to miss the shot.
And a foul on Mike Nardi, first foul in the game. Price will go to the bench. Craig Ostrey will come in for UConn. There's been some talk with Connecticut, if the Huskies were to lose their last two games tonight against Villanova, then Saturday at Georgetown, that they may not make the NIT.
No, I don't think that's going to be the case.
Only 32 teams make the NIT, and they have a selection committee, a blue ribbon panel, started last year, trying to fill these 32 spots with the next best teams that don't make the NCAA tournament. Good work on the boards by Connecticut, and another Villanova foul as Curtis Kelly, freshman off the bench, was strong on the glass.
Interestingly enough, there's not a real clock out, body out philosophy here. It's go and attack the basket and get the rebound. Stays with it.
So Kelly, a freshman to the line, shooting two. Coach, how much do you think the RPI is overhyped? And, you know, you saw the resume earlier for Villanova, 21 RPI, 6 strength of schedule. You talked about the Lunardi numbers. How legitimate is it for Villanova to be, you know, a team at 7-9 in the Big East, but maybe still gets in because that RPI is good?
I thought Coach Bam at Syracuse had a valid comment about that. He said you're rewarded to a certain extent for going to play difficult games on the road, irrespective of winning them or not. And I think the winning them or not part of that. Oh, wow.
Sumter banking it in. But Villanova has won a lot of the games that they've played. They beat Texas. They beat Iowa at a conference. They won at Oklahoma. And in conference play, they've won at Georgetown, at Providence. They've knocked off Notre Dame and Louisville.
Well, they've got all the numbers that you want. But the definitive number is wins and losses and in league. And if they lose tonight, it's 500 at best. And I would not want to put it on beating Syracuse at Wachovia Center on Saturday, a neutral court.
Well, you go back a few years ago, Notre Dame back-to-back years was 9-7 in the Big East and did not get into the NCAA tournament as Nardi misfires.
But Notre Dame's strength of schedule was abysmal. Like this year, Notre Dame is still 3-0-3 in strength of schedule. As you alluded to earlier, they played a very good schedule. This game is really important. And right now, it's all Nova.
Villanova's 3 out of 8 from the field. UConn 1 out of 10. Tough shot. The beat gets Johnson's rebound. And a Villanova foul. 13 foul on the Wildcats. Jim Calhoun squad down 6, 5 minutes in. College basketball fan, you got the best week and a half of the year coming up. Championship week starting tomorrow. A lot of the mid-major conference championships will be decided here soon. And the Big East tournament among many of the major championships that get underway midweek next week on the ESPN Family Networks. Connecticut ball down 6. The Huskies just 1 out of 11 from the field early on.
If I'm UConn, I'm doing something here to get Dyson and Adrian off.
Robinson's shot is off. Connecticut now 1 of 12.
The most challenged outside shooter on the team takes a critical shot down 6.
Robinson, a freshman. Connecticut stock with freshmen and sophomores as Reynolds turns it over. Here's Dyson taking it in on Nardi. Good move. Couldn't score off the window, but he's fouled. Fourth team foul already in Villanova. None on Connecticut. More college basketball later tonight. ACC Wednesday presented by Staples at 9 Eastern. Duke, winners of 4 in a row, taking on Maryland, winners of 5 straight, and then a great game on ESPN2 in the Big 12. Kevin Durant and the Longhorns taking on Texas A&M. Texas gave up 100 points to A&M in their first meeting in College Station. As Dyson gets the first free throw to drop, foul was on Sumter, his first. The beat back into the game, and Curtis Kelly will go to the bench for Connecticut.
On that drive, there's not many two guards that could handle that ball, change hands, change direction, and change speed the way Dyson did there.
He's really come on. Freshman from Rockville, Maryland, same hometown as Kevin Durant, by the way. Different school, but Dyson from Rockville, and he's averaging over his last 5 games, 20 points per at 27 at Syracuse, 23 against Louisville the other day, hit 6 threes in that game. Sumter spotting up. His threes in and out, rebound by Adrian.
The number that impressed me for Dyson is 2, and that's 2 teeth knocked out. He's a former high school football player. He lost 2 teeth, went back into the game, and didn't want to get any stitches.
Robinson missed on one end. Nardi on the other end. Cunningham couldn't corral and finish. And the third leading rebounder in the Big East Conference, Jeff Adrian with the board. Robinson, another attempt, and still can't find it from outside. Thabeet is there, gets clobbered, and puts it home off block.
What a great play by Thabeet. He kept the ball up high, he kept his focus and eyes on the target, and he finished and paid it off with scoring. That's one of the few times I've seen him where he's been in that kind of congestion and come out on top. Take a look at this now. Look at him grab that ball. Look at his eyes. Right up on the target. He never brought the ball below his forehead. Duncan and Shaq won't do it any better tonight playing in the NBA than that young guy just did.
There's a lot of folks that think, as Connecticut commits its first team foul, that's on Ostry. A lot of people think that Thabeet, if he were to leave Connecticut, even though his numbers aren't great, would be a high draft pick because of his potential.
He's a lock on the first round. There are no centers in the game with his size, his strength. He's got quick feet. Later on, we'll see him. He's got soccer feet. He's got legitimate 7'2". He's got outstanding hands.
Reynolds is fouled shooting a 3. There are some NBA scouts here, including Philadelphia 76ers Executive Vice President Larry Brown, who might be here for more than just scouting players. More on that as we go along tonight. But Brown, one of several scouts in attendance.
Now, Dyson's foul there was not very smart. I like his competitive spirit, and you definitely want to get a hand up on Reynolds, but he was so far out.
That's Dyson's first, second on UConn, 5 team fouls on Villanova. That's a rare miss for Reynolds at the line. He had made 26 of his last 27 of the stripe before that miss.
UConn substitution number 3, Doug Wiggins.
Wiggins into the game for Connecticut, replacing Dyson.
Reynolds doesn't have the blow-by speed you like to see to get to the paint. He's become more crafty with the ball.
2 misses for Reynolds, an 85% free throw shooter. Nine-6 Villanova, Connecticut shooting 13% from the field. But 7 minutes in, down just 3 points.
This is what's carried Villanova, a swarming collective defense.
Adrian from just inside the arc. Rebounded by Cunningham.
So far we've seen no drives and no real post-ups to speak of by UConn.
Clark in the lane, had it blocked. Connecticut leads the nation in blocks. 6 straight year they've done that. No one's ever done it that many years in a row. Johnson on the drive, offensive foul. No basket. First on Johnson, third on UConn.
That's a good foul. I call that a foul of commission. I'll take that every time. My player goes to the basket hard. They step in there right at the end. And again, I feel the location of that charge should have been a no call.
You saying that because it was too low under the basket?
Exactly. I mean, that is the one NBA rule that the collegians should adapt. There may be another one or two, but that one for sure. The uniqueness of the college game relative to the NBA game is special, but that rule would be beneficial to all parties involved.
Reynolds, a deep three. Johnson has it for UConn. Huskies pushing it with Wiggins. Austrey's three, not there. Adrian sticks it home. UConn with it one.
And as much as they scored off the rebound, you see the challenge Connecticut team from the perimeter shooting. They have no shooters to speak of other than Dyson.
Reynolds, another look at a three. Missed that time. Villanova's already hoisted eight threes, made two, and those are the first two of the game. One by Nardi, one by Reynolds. Both teams are shooting under 22% in the first 8 minutes. Johnson hits the beat again, hammered this time by Sumter. That's two now on Sumter.
You're going to see Connecticut on the glass. They shoot outside. Adrian gets in there, rebounds with two hands, brings it down, but nevertheless finishes with gusto and in traffic.
This begins Championship Week presented by Dick's. March 1st through March 11th, 89 men's and women's games, 34 championships. Every single game, ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPN Classic. Games also available on ESPN 360. A terrific championship week once again. Who knows what will happen in the Big East tournament? Syracuse has won it each of the last 2 years. Everybody remembers what happened last year. Jerry McNamara going wild. At that time, going in to play at Madison Square Garden, the Orange was on the bubble, but they clinched the automatic berth with winning four in a row in New York.
They come off a drubbing of some 40 points by DePaul at DePaul and buck up and come back and win that Big East tourney. That was a tremendous accomplishment. Led by Matt Namara.
That's what's so great about this time of year. You and I did that game, and both of us said there's no way Syracuse is going to the tournament.
Exactly. Matt Namara walked off the court crying, head down. What a great competitor he was.
Who knows? It might happen again in the Big East this year. Well, the one team winning four in a row. Top four seeds get a bye in the first round.
The beat misses, but Adrian does it. And Connecticut has the lead thanks to a 9-1 run over the last 4:45.
Adrian's due with a 6'8 power forward should do. Get on the offensive board. How about the beat's catches?
Already five rebounds for Adrian, who's third in the league in that category. 14 double-doubles for Adrian, number one in the Big East. And then Nardi gives it away.
Look at this pass. Look, watch that catch. Now, he brought that one down below his numbers. But there you see Adrian. They came to double and help out a little bit. On the beat, that always opens up a run to the rim or a lane to the offensive glass.
8 second chance points for UConn.
Nova goes to its 1-2-2 here. What you want to do is change it up the sideline and then in the middle and attack.
Nobody picks up Price. He can't hit the three, though. And Adrian gets another offensive rebound.
They don't have a legitimate outside shooter except for Dyson.
And then a foul on the play as Dyson took it to the hole. That's 17 fouls already on Villanova and two on Nardi. Sumter also has two. A lot of people think that the guy that UConn misses most from last year's team is Rashad Anderson because he could hit that three. The Huskies don't have that guy this year.
No, they don't have a... And they've usually had a signature player in that shooting spot of Ray, going back to the days of Ray Allen. Doing all pro five or six times, but I love the beat's attitude. Look at the way he came in there. Someone just got a T here. And I'll be interested to see who he gives it on. Now, if the beat was in that second spot, and he went flying in there. He has energy and enthusiasm. You talked before, some think, I can definitively say he'd be a high first round draft pick. He already shoots his three throws like the great NBA players. Wallace, Shaquille O'Neal, he's in the 50%.
He's gotten better too over the last five games. The beat 71% free throws over the last five. Third leading shot blocker in the country.
Look at the beat. He's in there enthusiastically.
Oh, he definitely shoved Cunningham.
Because Cunningham grabbed his hand. And I actually, if I'm Calhoun, like to see that, because his posture has been too deferral in terms of his, they definitely called the tee before, but he has not been assertive, and I like to see him combative like that. Oh, wait, they might have called. The coaches don't know what they called, and we're trying to find out as well.
Well, they obviously called a technical on Villanova because Dyson just shot a free throw, and now Nardi's going to shoot one.
Double team. Kind of a bailout, I think. There was a hand grab there, and then there was the push.
So a personal foul on Thabeet. All right, now they're saying just a technical on Thabeet. So they shot that second free throw because Dyson was already at the line. And because they're going to shoot the technical, they didn't need anybody under the basket. So only a technical on Thabeet and a personal foul as well. His first. And the fourth on UConn.
I like to see Thabeet with the fire in the belly. He hasn't learned to divorce his off-court personality from his on-court persona. And once he does that and really enjoys kicking some butt down there, he's going to love the game a whole lot more.
He's only been in the States for about 4 years. He's from Tanzania, played his high school ball in Houston. Reynolds knocks down his second three. Villanova had been 1 of 11 since that three by Reynolds, his second triple.
And Connecticut went under the ball pick three. You don't want to do that against Reynolds or Nardi. You got to go over the top or you're going to pay the consequence.
Price inside the three-point line drops it through. UConn back up one. A big game for Villanova tonight. The Wildcats 7-7 in the league. Many think that they have to win one out of two. They play Syracuse at home on Saturday to secure a berth in the NCAA tournament.
There they go over the pick on that.
Reynolds had it blocked, but a foul. 15 foul on UConn. That's going to go on Johnson. That's his second personal. Road on Thursday presented by IBM. Both great ACC matchups on ESPN and ESPN2. All teams vying for the ACC title at 7 Eastern. Virginia Tech, Virginia on ESPN. ESPN2 at 9, it's Carolina, Georgia Tech. Two important games tomorrow on ESPN and ESPN2. And how about Virginia Tech and what the Hokies have been able to do this year? Didn't look good early as they were losing the teams that ACC champs normally don't lose to out of conference like Marshall, but they've been terrific in league play.
They've done it with their defense, and the defense is the common denominator to success.
Reynolds at the line shooting two. I would have to think that as a point guard, Scotty Reynolds gets to the line as much as anybody. Taking a look again at the push by Thabeet. They called the technical on Thabeet, personal foul as well.
It's always a retaliatory move that gets it because they had held his hand, and then the referee doesn't see that, but he sees you on the push.
That's already five attempts at the free throw line for Reynolds. He's had four games this year where he's had at least 9 attempts at the line. That's a lot for a point guard.
Now, what they can't do is they can't be content, UConn, just to break that press. They've got to make them pay a price for pressing, or they're going to turn the screws up Villanova. They've got to look to score against the press.
Reynolds took a shot to the face as Dyson was trying to create space. Ball out of bounds. It will stay UConn basketball.
Nothing intentional about that. He pressures. He sweeps and pulls through a little high. Usually you pull through across your legs, but that was not intentional. I like Reynolds staying in here and not going for a bailout on that.
Thabeet with the left hand, no. And it will go to Villanova as the beat gets called for his second personal. 16 fouls now on UConn.
They've got to make more of a concerted effort to go to the beat, and he's complying tonight by trying to be more assertive to the glass, creating catches for himself, and going on into traffic on the boards.
Coach, Connecticut is on pace for 96 field goal attempts. They got 24 shots already up in just over 10 minutes.
Yeah, we don't need that shot clock tonight.
Of course, they've only made five of those 24. Reynolds again sneaks down the lane and scores. Dyson down court. And a Villanova foul. No goaltending on Sheridan. Nova by three, 9 minutes to go first half. Time now for SportsCenter 30 at 30 with Scott Reese.
All right, Dave, for some NFL news, the Ravens cleared some cap room, waiving running back Jamal Lewis, who is the team's all-time leading rusher. They do hope to re-sign Lewis for less money down the line. And college hoops, Oklahoma State coach Sean Sutton suspending leading scorer Mario Bogan for last night's headbutting incident in their victory against Kansas State. He won't play Saturday at Baylor Sports Center after Maryland Duke, and ESPN has details all the time, guys.
Well, certainly Oklahoma State needs to win at Baylor and have a lot of success in the Big 12 tournament, maybe have to win the Big 12 tournament to get into the NCAA tournament.
Both teams extending the pickup point now. This is somewhat of a bother press by Connecticut, the purpose of which is to create even a greater, a faster tempo.
Reynolds lost his footing but did not travel. Tried to scoop it home. It will stay Villanova basketball, 16 to shoot.
When you pick your dribble up along the baseline, your teammates have to deploy to each corner, and then, in fact, if they're denied, cut to the rim. His teammates didn't help him out in that situation.
Both teams shooting under 30% from the field. I'm sure you watched some of that Georgetown-Syracuse game. Sean, Jay, and Raph were commenting during the game that it seemed like a classic Big East game going back to the 80s. And this is a different kind of classic Big East game. A lot of physical play, a lot of fouls being called.
There's no tempo or flow to this game. The one thing you can count on as a constant is when you score on UConn, they get the ball out of the net and come back on you as quick as anyone. Keep watching Dyson for that throughout the game.
That's the 15th foul called in the game. Second personal on Cunningham, ninth on Villanova. Price, nice feed to Kelly underneath, puts it in.
What a catch by Kelly. And then he slid off the charge. The pass was terrific. I like high passes around the rim.
And UConn with 10 of its 17 points coming in the paint. Reynolds off the screen. He'll launch from way out. And long rebound by Cunningham. Sheridan can't pop through. Clark is there. And finally cleared by Stanley Robinson.
Cunningham, Clark, and Redding are all the same player. They're all blender players.
Offensive foul on Kelly. Scotty Reynolds did a good job getting position, and Kelly gets called for the offensive foul, his first. UConn trailing by one. Back in stores where Connecticut trails by one, no scholarship seniors for Jim Calhoun's team. So on senior night, the only senior on the roster, walk-on Marty Gagne from Vernon, Connecticut. And he's a fan favorite here. He came out, and the students that were here about an hour and a half before tip-off in a huge standing ovation. And also Dale Nozzle, the top student fan, getting his jersey retired, so to speak.
Looks like a Blue Man Group wannabe.
He doesn't know if he's a blue man or a white man based on the mix of colors. Blue on one side, white on the other. Sumter, that's a tough shot, but he got it to go. Villanova by three. Sumter out there with two personal fouls.
And Villanova's spacing and the fact that they created spacing by completing their cuts outside the arc enabled them to get that. Now Nova goes to a 1-2-2 zone.
Terrible pass by Robinson.
Terrible feeding angle and way too early in the possession.
Goaltending on the other end. Redding will get credited with a hoop. Robinson.
Calhoun's very close to getting a TU. He's been on these refs. This is a play-in game. This is their play-in game relative to an NCAA bid here. They can't get a bid without a win tonight. UConn.
You think Connecticut needs to obviously win the last two regular season games and then get to the Big East title game?
I think if they did that, they deserve a bid.
Foul on the floor before the shot. You know, one-on-one situation. Josh Boone, Charlie Villanueva, Marcus Williams would be seniors had they not gone to the NBA. Boone and Williams after last year's Elite Eight run.
They could have used any or all. Imagine if they had all of them.
But obviously that's where we are in college basketball, especially at a place like UConn, Ben Gordon, Emeka Okafor, other guys that left early. And the 2004 national championship team.
Well, I believe Boone and Villanueva made mistakes. They could have refined their game. They would have been much more self-assured, developed that confidence, integrated aspects like use of the offhand.
Now, we talked earlier about Thabeet. Do you think he's ready for the NBA?
No, of course he's not. But, you know, neither was Bynum. And Bynum's going to be a terrific player. Let's not forget UConn had signed him, too. The kid out of New Jersey with the Los Angeles Lakers, their rookie center. Look at Nova's space now. Why'd they keep that floor?
Sumter got it blocked by Kelly, but getting it back and sticking it in is Drummond. And Jim Calhoun, irate with Curtis Kelly, calls timeout.
Jim is all over Kelly here, deservedly so. Now look at Sumter right there. Take that ball up hard. Well, we've got a large strip right there. That's what basketball.
Villanova by six back here in Storrs. Huge game for the Wildcats trying to secure an NCAA tournament berth. A win today against Connecticut would ensure the Wildcats have a 500 record in league play.
The UConn guards are 1-for-10 at this point, and they don't leave dice in the ball, their best shooting guard.
And after that miss by Wiggins, now 1-for-11.
Right.
Reynolds already 11 points in the game, gets fouled. That's the 18th foul on UConn, first personal on Mandeldove, so a 1-1 coming up for Reynolds.
When Kelly wasn't strong at that rebound, Coach Calhoun went down. He couldn't get Mandeldove in the game fast enough.
And then he comes right out, and Gavin Edwards comes into the game.
And he's taking him out and giving him a 1-4 relative to his talking on defense on the pick and his performance in regarding the pick and roll.
Reynolds hits the front end of the 1-1. He's got 12. There's no question this has been a challenging year for Jim Calhoun. He knew it was going to be tough after losing all those great players from last year's team to the NBA. Reynolds gets both to go. He's got 13. Villanova has an 8-point lead, under six to go in the first half.
See, now they're confidently zoning up with particular attention being played to number 11.
Had Dyson with 4 points, and those are all at the line. He has not made a shot from the field. Adrian gets fouled inside by Drummond.
The one guy with the railroad tracks on his back, that's all you've got to find if you're going to zone here. Those other ones, I'd take my percentages.
We've got 19 fouls called in the first half and 14 made shots from the field.
The fouls have distorted the rhythm of the game.
Adrian, a 57% free throw shooter. Connecticut last in the Big East as a team in foul shooting.
Well, he does everything wrong here. He pulls out of his shot. He doesn't fall through. He aims the ball. He has too much motion in his arm. Doesn't come forward when he releases it.
But as you see by comparison from those stats last year, one of the most improved players in the Big East, and certainly getting more of an opportunity this year. Just one start last year with all that talent on the UConn roster. A starter the entire 2006-2007 season, leading the Big East in double-doubles. One more than Aaron Gray of Pittsburgh, who many thinks the Big East player of the year.
I'm going with Green at Georgetown in that category.
It's a good pick, too. Reynolds for another three. Not there. He's 2 out of 7 from three. Dyson pushing, looking for his first field goal, instead the kick out. And then another turnover by Connecticut. That's six by the Huskies in the first half. And that kind of year for Jim Calhoun's squad.
They really don't have a presence in the backcourt. The B does not emerge as a low block scorer.
Reynolds again getting into the lane and scoring. He's got 15. And Villanova's opened up a 9-point edge.
And gotten all these paint points without post-ups. Just by middle game drives, layups, and transition.
Austrie, no. Rebound by Reynolds. 15 points already for Scotty Reynolds, the outstanding freshman from Herndon, Virginia. In Big East games, he's the fourth leading scorer in the conference. Crowd wanted a walk. Reynolds able to hit Sheridan. Good job by Edwards. Hold his ground. They will stay Villanova basketball. 16 to shoot.
Number 50, they call him Bump Sheridan. I thought it was because he played such a contact game, took charges, got the Attaboy Award for doing all the dirty little things. He said, no, it's because I was moving around in my mom's womb. That's the inside story.
Literally the inside story. They had a big game in the win over Connecticut last year when these two teams split the regular season crown at a double-double in the win at home against Connecticut. Reynolds lost it on his way to the goal, and Price out of there with it for Connecticut 2-on-1. Villanova stopped running on defense. They heard the buzzer go off, but it was no shot clock violation because Connecticut had possession, and Austrie gets the basket.
You stop on the whistle.
Reynolds on Austrie. Finds Clark. Can't get the bounce. Out to Price. Looking to push it again. 3-on-2 for UConn. And a blocking foul is called as Redding try to step in and take the charge. 7-point Villanova lead on the road. 23 of game time. Villanova leading Connecticut by 7. Coach, take us inside the play.
Well, here you can see Reynolds with the ball covered by Austrie. Sheridan's coming over to set the pick. Adrian's covering him. And as the screen comes here, go ahead, run it. Stop. Okay, now number one, you want to push your man into the pick. Number two, when this guy's out here, you don't want to get beat by the ball. So we should have Adrian out there. Adrian's nowhere in the picture. He turns the corner. Adrian's still coming. And then they do the number one thing you can never do defensively, leave the ball. You never leave the ball. You can leave your jewelry, you can leave your girlfriend, but you can't leave the ball.
Price at the line shooting 2. And you talked earlier about Connecticut really struggling to find a guard to step up and score consistently, and it got to be a lead guard, and they're hoping A.J. Price will eventually be that guy. 3.5 assists per game for Price, a sophomore. Obviously, he's been through a lot, as many people know. A couple years ago, a brain hemorrhage, almost lost his life, and then missed last year due to suspension. Here's Sumter on the drive, got it stripped. Marcus Johnson came over and poked it loose. Here's Price, finds Austrie. And Dyson's 3. Clark couldn't hold it. It'll go to UConn.
Nice ball movement and an excellent shot right there. Here you see the drive, going up for the block, comes off the outside shoulder. Adrian with his inside hand. Exactly how you want to block it.
Into the backcourt for Price. 7 blocks for Connecticut.
They settle right into a 2-3 zone.
Look at the 3-point shooting. 0 for 8 for UConn. Villanova started 2-2, so Wildcats just 1 for their last 8 from 3. Austrie's not the guy you want to leave, though, if you're Villanova. At Gamble Pavilion, he shoots better than 41% from 3.
And many a night, his dad comes up. His dad makes a 2-hour drive from Stanford to come up and shoot with his son after study hall. What a nice story that is. His dad's from Jamaica.
Yeah, Vincent Austrie, who owns a construction business in Stanford, will often come up to stores despite being exhausted from a long day's work to help rebound for his son. Nice strip this time by Dyson. UConn can tie it with a three. Price on the drive. Huskies within one at the two-minute mark. And Villanova calls for time. 8-0 run by UConn.
Take a look at this. Nice layoff right here. Dribble penetration. Rises up to his middle game.
And 8 straight points for the Huskies coming up later tonight. ACC Wednesday presented by Staples pits two hot ACC teams, Maryland and Duke. And on ESPN2 at 9 Eastern, Texas taking on Texas A&M. Kevin Durant, 25 points per game, 11 rebounds per game.
The total package. This guy takes it to the rim. There you see him running the floor for the transition. How about this post up right here? And what I loved is how he made the right decision of the route coming off the screen and how he utilized the screen.
A couple weeks ago, Kevin Durant's dad came out and said, you know, it's not definite that my son Kevin is going to the NBA after one season. Do you believe him?
No.
You'd have to think Durant's going to be one or two, right, if he comes out.
At this point, they all feel that way. Push him into the pit, get out there. He's splitting that seam every time.
Reynolds again does so well getting down the lane. Gets to the free throw line a lot. He's got 17 points in this game. Already been to the line 7 times in the first half.
And that's all on Adrian. Who else did they expect to come out of the timeout with? They're going to come to Reynolds.
Adrian trying to get it up on the window and rebounded by Sumter.
Sumter might have lost his bounce, but he didn't lose his toughness.
At one time, a lot of people thought Sumter was just going to be a fantastic player, but he's had that left knee repaired twice. Still having a great year. 17 points per game, third in the league. Speaking of having a great year, Scotty Reynolds, 20 points now in the game, and he just gets better and better.
You got to go box and one concept within your man and man. And speaking of Sumter, you know that you've been injured when on senior night, the trainer Jeff Pierce is accompanying you with your parents to the floor to get the recognition. I thought that was a nice story for Sumter.
And Sumter's been bothered by injuries this year, too. And UConn got within one, and then the last couple possessions is again struggled on offense.
3-second differential between shot clock and game clock here.
Scotty Reynolds with 20 of the 33 Villanova points. He gets into the paint again. Can't hit the fall away. Kept alive by Sumter. And it will stay Villanova basketball as Wiggins couldn't handle him on the baseline for UConn.
Dave, the number one rule of defending the ball pick is don't let the ball beat you. Usually it's the small, because it's a big on small pick. You're better off making him make another pass that you can make a rotation to or that you can get help back to than letting what he's doing. Who do you think this one will be for?
I think the guy with the ball.
Right. There will be a pick right there. Wisely pulls it back out. Way too much time.
5 seconds to go in the half.
Now they do what they should have done defensively.
Reynolds again gets into the lane. Sumter gets it away. Won't go. They still got a good shot. Scotty Reynolds did well to get into the paint. 20 points in the first half for Reynolds. He had 3 threes, got to the line 7 times, and Villanova leads UConn on the road by 6. Let's go to the studio now, the UPS halftime report, and Scott Reese.
All right, Dave, so UConn trying to...
You've got a hedge, which means you get out and not allow the man to turn the corner. You've got to help, and I'm talking about the big man now covering the corresponding big who's setting the pick. Then you've got to recover, rebound, and run. They're missing 1 and 2. There is no hedge, and there is no help by the Connecticut players.
Reynolds has been terrific in the first half each of his last 3 games. Villanova 1-1 in the previous 2. We'll see how they finish here in stores, trying to win here for just the 2nd time at Gamble Pavilion. Reynolds 6-14. The rest of the team 5-19 in the first half. Leading scorer for Connecticut was Jeff Adrian with 6 points and 7 rebounds. Here's Nardi. Got it blocked by Thabit. Connecticut with 8 blocks as a team. Cunningham tried to save it. It will go to UConn. Our UBS first half stats. Neither team shot it well from 2-point range or 3-point range. Connecticut dominated the glass.
The beats blocked there. was not a very good move by Nardi. The best mismatch in the game is the small driving the big, and the big that switched off rebounding the ball.
Adrian finds Johnson in the lane, and Connecticut back within four. First points for Johnson on the night.
That's a classic attack of that 1-2-2 press. Change the ball, put it up the sideline, bring it back to the middle.
Entry pass to Cunningham, playing the three personal fouls. Into the hands of Jerome Dyson. In transition, Johnson's jumper. Back-to-back hoops for Marcus Johnson to get the Huskies within a deuce. A win for Connecticut tonight would get the Huskies to 7-8. Maybe tied with Villanova, but Scotty Reynolds might have something to say about that. That's 23 points now for Reynolds, the outstanding freshman.
Well, he's green-lighted and his teammates defer to him. And as we said, Nardi has subordinated himself for the benefit of the team, giving him confidence.
Might be the best freshman guard in the country, Scotty Reynolds. Foul inside on Villanova is going to go on Sheridan, his second, first on Villanova in the half.
Statistically speaking, I would not take him, for example, over Chris Connelly. No one has meant more to his team, nor has a team won more, and obviously ranked 1-2 or 3
Mike Conley,
year
Ohio State.
Than Mike Conley at Ohio State. Particularly so on a 3.5-to-1 assist to turnover ratio, not to mention his defense, and he's played alongside practically an all-freshman roster as well.
Dante Cunningham just got called for his fourth personal foul. Second on Villanova in the half.
Now that's a loss, because he's a guy who understands how to space, set a screen, defend, post up, and rebound. He does all those hustle board components.
Oh, Reynolds comes up with a great play, and he's going to drive on Price. Beautifully done. Scotty Reynolds for the third straight game now with 25 points.
And how about that hesitation dribble? Now they go back to a 2-3 zone. They'll look for number 11, Dyson, and then they'll concede shots in the perimeter. There's where you want to go, right there.
Adrian can't hit it, though. And Drummond gets to the loose ball. Here comes Reynolds, and the Wildcats leading by 7.
But it is Adrian's shot. Don't have a problem with players if they miss a good shot. And it's their shot. People ask me a lot about the kid at Texas, Durant. I'm going to tell you something. He knows what shot he wants and how to get it.
Reynolds got clobbered by his own man, Drummond. Still got it underneath to Sumter. Back on the other end, Johnson goes down hard. Contact, but no foul call. Reynolds again in the front court. Skips to a wide open Nardi. Reynolds for a career high. There it is, 28 for Scotty Reynolds. And it's a 12-point Villanova lead. It's been all Reynolds tonight at Gamble, trying to single-handedly put Villanova in the NCAA tournament. All right, Scott, here Villanova's opened up its largest lead of the night, a 10-0 run over the last 90 seconds, and Scotty Reynolds has been the main culprit. 8 points during that span. He's got 28 tonight. He's at 5 threes. And we were just talking during the break. You mentioned Mike Conley. We're just trying to talk about some of the best freshman guards. You get Ty Lawson at Carolina, Sharon Collins at Kansas. You mentioned the fact that he's not getting the minutes as some of the other guys on that team are, but got to put Scotty Reynolds up there among the best freshman guards in the country.
Yep, no question about that.
Jerome Dyson's pretty good freshman guard, too. 14 points per game on the year. Struggling a bit tonight. In fact, that's his first made shot from the field. 7 points in the game now.
But they got the ball, and your point is so well taken. First made shot, they got the ball in the hands of their best shooter. They've got no chance if he can't come up with some scores.
He was 0 for 6 prior to that made three. A win for Villanova ensures the Wildcats of at least a 500 finish in the Big East and probably a berth in the NCAA tournament. This would give them 20 wins on the year. And of their 9 losses, 8 have been against teams that right now have at least 20 wins.
And I'll tell you something, there's Rodman-like in this category, and certainly not in Colton style or Air style. He gets that rebound, he finds that perimeter guy when he can't put it back up.
How about Sumter again underneath, cleaning up the miss by Reynolds, 8 points for Sumter on the night.
With 2 torn ACLs being repaired. Now they're in the zone again. They'll try to fade and Shaver to Dyson.
And Adrian gets hammered by Sheridan. He'll go to the line for 2. Villanova leading by 11 on the road. Back at Gamble Pavilion, where Villanova's trying to win for just the 2nd time ever. Scotty Reynolds has been the story for the Wildcats with 28 points.
Here he gets the steal, but what really entices me to watch him is his change of pace. I love that change of pace dribble. Now he drives here, gets hung up, but has the presence of mind and the verbal to see Sumter and feeds him high around the basket. Now he comes around for that handoff, squares up. Look at his feet and balance and the economy of motion he had relative to his setup of creating that shot with a change of pace, change of direction.
How much of what he's doing tonight is him? How much of it is UConn's defense?
Well, it's a great question. It's a 50-50 proposition here, but UConn has not taken the number one aspect of pick and roll defense to heart here tonight, and that is not let the small turn the corner with the ball. Don't get beat by the ball. Their bigs are not getting out. And when they are getting out, they're getting out late, and they provide a crease or a seam. We showed it time and time again.
Adrian gets them both. Scotty Reynolds, a McDonald's All-American, was all set to go to Oklahoma. And on the day of the McDonald's All-American game, he got a phone call from Kelvin Sampson. Sampson telling him he was going to Indiana. And I remember talking with Scotty that day. He was not happy about it. He was upset that Sampson was leaving. And you get a sense then that perhaps he wanted out, and eventually he did and was released from his commitment. Ends up with Jay Wright at Villanova. Sumter can't get it to drop. Rebounded finally by Connecticut's Robinson.
I like Jay Wright's call of that timeout. Go to your senior. He's breaking his back for you on the glass. He's doing a yeoman's job defensively. Reward him a little bit. Catch him off guard because it's been so much Robinson. Good call.
A.J. Price working on Nardi, draws the foul. That's 14 fouls already in the half on Villanova. 3rd on Nardi. ACC Wednesday presented by Staples coming up 9 Eastern on ESPN HD. 14th ranked Duke, winners of 4 in a row, taking on a hot Maryland team, which has won 5 straight. Texas A&M and Texas at 9 Eastern on ESPN2.
If I'm UConn, I go to the 7'3 guy with the soccer feet and the lobster-like hands. I go to Thabit.
Now Thabit, with 5 points in the game, only taken 5 shots, does have 6 rebounds and a couple of blocks. By the way, that Maryland-Duke game will tip at 9:10 Eastern time. Duke has not lost since losing to Maryland as part of that skid the Blue Devils were on a few weeks back.
And tonight, if you're any kind of Big East aficionado, you can say I saw him win, because it's Scotty Reynolds on the come. He could very easily eclipse 30.
He's got 28 with 15 minutes left in the game. But Connecticut is pulled back within 8. Adrian can't score. There's the beat. You talked about his hands. He couldn't put it in, though. But he did get fouled.
Never forget, it's a vertical game. And how about that bounce and timing? Not to mention coming from way across the rim. He's not even in the picture. See him come from outside in there to get that rebound. That was a big time rebound. He came the width of the lane, kept it up, and I love that kid's energy and enthusiasm. He has an excitement and passion for play.
You think of the potential that this guy has compared to some of the other big men in the college game. I mean, take Roy Hibbert, for example. You know, a lot of people think Roy Hibbert's going to be a lottery pick, and he might end up being a very good pro, but you think of the potential that this kid has, the beat. 7'3", just a freshman. A lot of NBA scouts are salivating over this kid.
And let's not forget, he's playing with Green, probably the MVP, Jeff Green, and then he's got a 180 shooter, one of the best shooters in the Big East, Walls alongside him.
Here's a Connecticut foul, first team foul. You saw Larry Brown, executive of the 76ers, who's here doing some scouting of players and perhaps of coaches. Larry Brown has become a big fan of Jay Wright. Brown lives very close to the Villanova campus and often attends Villanova practices. And there's been some speculation that should Mo Cheeks be relieved of his duties as head coach, that the 76ers would be interested in Jay Wright as their head coach.
I don't know that. You know, I know one thing. I was at the practices last week with Larry, a couple of them, and he really enjoys, his children go to school there. He lives in the area. He likes Jay a lot.
There's Reynolds again. Now 31 for Scotty Reynolds. Robinson answers for three on the other end. Big shot there for Robinson.
Right now, I'm telling my guys, there's only one guy wearing number one out there. Let's find him and tag him, identify him. Let's get out here now on this pick.
31 points. And here he goes again, looking for three more. Not there. Too strong. Robinson gets to the loose ball. Connecticut still in the game. Down only 7 points. They're trying to feed the beat, and an offensive foul has caused the beat just threw Reynolds to the ground. That's three on the beat, two on UConn.
Take a look at Reynolds here. Nice hesitation, nice change of pace. Back dribble for separation. He used to dance a little bit behind those picks. He's gotten over that bad habit. He understands the three-point shot.
Reynolds 6 of 12 from 3. Thabit going to go to the bench with those three personal fouls. Kelly back into the game for UConn. Nova's got 48 points. Reynolds has 31 of them. Sumter, the next high man, with 8 points. Missed that time. Clark with the offensive rebound and off the window for two. Villanova back up nine.
The role definition and delineation is so good on Villanova's team. And it's nice to see them all concerned about the left-hand column only, the way they defer to the freshman and encourage his scoring.
Adrian, nice job on the low block. That's 10 points now for Jeff Adrian to go along with 7 rebounds. Preseason All-Big East performer that's double the scoring average from a year ago.
Well, he has a classic four-man body, and that time he utilizes it.
He's going to be a good Big East forward in the next couple of years if he continues to progress at UConn. Clark feeds Sumter in the lane. Drew contact, no whistle, but he scored anyway. 10 points now for Sumter.
It's just a workhorse. Understands what his game is. He never takes a possession off.
Hardy has his degree in sociology. Hoping to get a couple wins in the NCAA tournament. Here he gets called for a foul. That's four on Sumter, 6 on Villanova.
Here you see him really want the ball. Flashes in there. Shot fake. I love the way he plays through the hit with his head on the target and gets the ball high in the glass. Let me underscore, high in the glass.
Scotty Reynolds just went to the bench. See how long he stays there. 12:21 on the clock. 9-point Villanova lead. And a foul. And Dyson got hit in the face as he was going up.
With 12:18 left, what they're doing is they're taking that 18 seconds and rest them through the TV timeout coming. He'll be back in when this TV timeout's over, unless they can space that lead a little bit.
And you wonder if Jay Wright's concerned now about the front court. Cunningham, Sumter, and Sheridan all have 4 fouls. There's still 12 minutes to go in the game. Doesn't have great depth in the front court.
Well, let's not forget, he's gone to zone throughout the game. And again, Dyson's the only hot hand and really only bona fide perimeter shooter. So he feels he's got that card to play.
So Sumter will go to the bench with 4. Kasim Drummond comes into the game. Sheridan is still out there with 4 fouls. Could be interesting if Connecticut continues to get it inside to Adrian, and if the beat gets back into the game and they feed him with all of Villanova's big men in foul trouble. 7-point Wildcat lead. They have the ball. Trying to secure at least a 500 finish in the Big East. They'll finish up with Syracuse at home on Saturday. Many think the Orange are in after their win over Georgetown on Monday. Many think Villanova would be in if it can beat Connecticut on the road tonight.
Well, this lineup is conducive to a stop for Connecticut. There's no hammer on the floor except for Nardi.
Shot clock at six. Nardi slips. Jump ball. It will go to UConn. And now a technical is called. Jim Calhoun wanted a travel.
Calhoun may have just got his second team.
So a technical foul on Jim Calhoun. UConn down seven. I look forward to that game. Also, A&M and Texas on ESPN2. Here, Villanova leading UConn by seven. Jim Calhoun just got teed up. That's the second technical on Connecticut. Hashim Fabik got teed up in the first half. So Nardi at the line shooting the technical free throw and got the first one. It was going to be Connecticut's ball anyway in a jump ball, but Calhoun wanted to travel on Nardi before he got tied up.
Not a calculated move. It's just frustration on Jim's part. He's frustrated with his players. He's frustrated with the season. It looked like it may have been a travel. He's trying to fight. If his players could exhibit that kind of passion. Now they're in the zone, and this mitigates the foul problems, as we have talked about.
I think you just hit it, Coach. Can his players exhibit that same kind of emotion and passion? Will that perhaps spark his players? As that three won't drop for Robinson. Connecticut shooting 33% from the floor and only three made threes in 13 attempts.
And barely over 50% from the free throw line.
That's a bad combination, those three right there. Scotty Reynolds back on the floor. 31 points in the game.
Two guys in my All-Big East freshman team. Tyson Gardman.
And Reynolds just lost it, so it goes to UConn. Nova leading by nine. Time now for a SportsCenter 30-30 update. And Scott Reese.
Okay, Dave. First from the NFL, the Ravens clearing some cap room, waiving running back Jamal Lewis, who is the team's all-time leading rusher, was the 2003 NFL Offensive Player of the Year. Baltimore does hope to re-sign Lewis at a later date. And Oklahoma State coach Sean Sutton suspending Mario Bogan for last night's headbutting incident against Kansas State. Bob Huggins also got a phone call from Coach Sutton with the regrets for the incident. Details on SportsCenter after basketball on ESPN News all the time. Yes.
All right, Scott, here Dyson misses a three, and it's Villanova basketball leading by nine. Wildcats win this game, and many think they're in the NCAA tournament. Based on what you've seen so far from Villanova, Coach, do they look like an NCAA tournament team?
Oh, yeah.
You say that without question, huh?
Their collective defense, their strength of schedule, their non-conference schedule.
Fouls on Dyson, that's his third. Fourth on UConn. So if UConn, in your opinion, is an NCAA tournament team, do you think they're a team that could do some damage in the postseason?
It depends on who they got bracketed against. They'd struggle with a team that put a defender, a quality defender, like say a UCLA puts Collison on a guy like Reynolds. He's going to shut him down. Conley shut him down too, another freshman.
Villanova has three big men in foul trouble. Cunningham and Sumter on the bench with four fouls. Sheridan on the floor with four personal fouls. Scotty Reynolds has been the story tonight for the Wildcats. He might outscore UConn before it's all said and done. He's got 31 points in the game. Here he goes again. Make it 33 for Scotty Reynolds. Getting to the hoop one more time. And another timeout. Jim Calhoun coming out of the floor. Upset with the defense of Jeff Adrian.
And again, you can see Adrian has been the culprit here because he's let him come right down. Look at, they're out there. Adrian should be rotating over here to this. He gets caught in no man's land and doesn't make a commitment. The beat's out there, so he can't turn the corner. And Adrian just kind of steps away from the charge. Credit Reynolds with a nice hesitation dribble and utilizing the screen well and an economy of motion and very decisive behind the screen.
And I know Connecticut's young, but that's just awful. Inexcusable defense there, and it's happened a lot tonight. Throw on Thursday presented by IBM. Boasts great ACC matchups on ESPN and ESPN2 at 7 Eastern. Virginia, Virginia Tech, great rivalry. And then at 9 Eastern, Carolina and Georgia Tech. We talked about freshman guards earlier. Javaris Crittenden of Georgia Tech, third among ACC freshmen in scoring, 14.5 points per game. Scotty Reynolds averaging 13 points per game, but that's up in league play, close to 17 points per contest, and he's got 33 of the 56 Nova points tonight.
He's got 40 in sight easily with 10 minutes to go.
Price can't score over Clark, and Reynolds gets the rebound. Clark got down the lane. And a Connecticut foul, a 15 foul against the Huskies. Let's take a look at our starter game track. Reynolds, a story for Villanova, along with bad shooting all the way around by UConn, especially at the foul line, 14 to 25.
What's not indicative there is Adrian's lack of help side in terms of his lack of defense on the screen and then coming to take that charge last time. You got to close that lane down. I mean, the kid's going down the lane time after time again.
Adrian, 10 points, 7 rebounds on the bench right now. Clark had started the last 6 games, but off the bench in this one. Great job by Sheridan as the UConn players mistimed their jumps. Reynolds can't hit it, though. Pulled in by Wiggins. Connecticut's got to make a move here soon. Down 11. 3 won't go for Ostry. Rebound by Edwards, and then a Villanova foul. That's the 8th Wildcat foul. If that's Sheridan, it is on Sheridan. That's 5. He's gone. Now what do you do if you're Jay Wright? Sumter and Cunningham also have 4 personal fouls, and Sheridan's out. You can't go to Ed Pinckney.
No. They would like to suit that up.
Pinckney, an assistant coach. He wouldn't mind down on the jersey for 9 more minutes.
They're fine because don't forget they can play zone. They've got an 11-point lead. It's been a scoring fest, so to speak, and they've got the hammer in that. Reynolds trumps all, particularly with the pick and roll coverage by UConn, or lack thereof.
Ed Pinckney, a member of that 1985 national title team. And Roly Massimino. Brick by Edwards on the front end of the 1-1. UConn doesn't have a field goal in the last 4 minutes, and they've missed 12 out of 26 free throws in the game. Here's Reynolds, who's got 33 on the night. What a great year in college basketball for freshmen. We've seen some amazing performances by Kevin Durant, Greg Oden, and the way Scotty Reynolds has played tonight. You got to tip your hat to this kid. Another jump ball. It will stay Villanova basketball. 1 second to shoot. Of course, Reynolds was about to turn it over right as I was complimenting him, but he did well to get on the floor and cause a tie. Marco Locar holds the Big East record for scoring in a game. 41 points against Pitt back in 1990. Reynolds 8 away from matching that. A lot of time left, 8.5 minutes to go. And again, 1 second to shoot.
He's getting away with a timeout without having to call one. She's substituting here.
Well, the officials are looking at the clock, coach, just to make sure that there is indeed 1 second on the shot clock. Cunningham. And how much time of the game clock as well is what they want to see. Let's see when they blow the whistle. It's not on the time, it's when the whistle blows.
Well, if ever you had to buck up and come together with a unity effort here, it's with 1 second on the shot clock, down 11, and the TV timeout impending in 30 seconds. This could be a big stop, not to mention that they could wrap a score around it afterwards.
Hornets finds Cunningham. He did get a shot off but couldn't score, and it will go to UConn. Cunningham dangerously close to getting called for his fifth foul. He went charging into a UConn player. Now he'll go back to the bench.
Well, they got the stop. Let's see if they can get the score.
A lot of time left. UConn can still get it into the lane. Kim Villanova's already had one guy foul out.
They're in the 2-3. Adrian is dangerous on the high post.
And he tried to feed Thabeet in the lane. Went off of Villanova.
Well, Wiggins, the little guard, tries to throw a bounce pass to the 7-3 guy. I hate bounce passes to bigs around the basket. And if you're ever going to call a guy a big, it's certainly the 7-3.
Oh, Reynolds collides with Wiggins. Unintentional. Reynolds was going for the ball. Certainly did mean to hurt Wiggins, but that had to hurt.
Here's your chance, coach, get the crowd back in the game. He's going for the ball. He tried to elbow him out of the way a little bit, but nothing intended or intentional.
Wiggins landed on his left wrist, but the thing that looked like it was the left hip, he landed on it, was the cause of the pain. That's what he's holding right now. Take a listen to this. Now you just hope Wiggins is all right. Tough fall, and again, Reynolds not trying to hurt him. Just going for the ball.
He's dizzy. He's got some stars there. I don't like the body language of the UConn team. I wish they were over there, you know, patting each other on the butt a little bit more, getting a little bit esprit de corps, ratcheting up that all for one, one for all attitude. You're at home here. Their student section so badly wants to get in the game.
Doug Wiggins, a freshman from East Hartford, averaging 7 points per game on the year. Has not scored tonight, does have a couple of rebounds. And trying to help him off the floor at midcourt. That's great to see.
It gives the Huskies a chance to convene and get together on their pick and roll coverage. If Nova's about anything, it's about spacing, shot prioritization, shot distribution and allocation. In this case, it goes to one Mr. Reynolds on his way to 40. On the road.
It's pretty good in a game where your team only has 56. Reynolds with 33, just committed his second personal foul, 19 foul. A.J. Price will shoot the free throws for the injured Doug Wiggins. Well, that, 1-1.
What I would commend Reynolds on is his possession by possession defensive thrust tonight.
Price can't hit the free throw. Connecticut now 14 of 27. They've taken 14 more free throws than UConn. Than Nova, and they've only made 5 more than the Wildcats.
They're a bad shooting team in their practice yesterday. They spent an inordinate amount of time on it.
UConn just 6-11 since an 11-0 start to the year. Young team losing top 6 players from a year ago. Shot clock at 6. Reynolds off the screen. Reynolds on the drive. Offensive foul. That's 3 on Reynolds. Reynolds with 33, but fouls last 2 plays for Villanova.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Rent-A-Center. For new brand name home furnishings and the easy way to make it your own, visit Rent-A-Center or rentacenter.com today.
Back at Campbell Pavilion, where Villanova behind Scotty Reynolds, 33 points, leads Connecticut by 11. Many of the Sweet 16 teams from a year ago stumbling in 2006-2007. Now, when we say definitely out, that's, of course, if George Mason, LSU, Connecticut does not win their respective conference tournaments. West Virginia, Villanova, Gonzaga, bubble teams, and if Villanova wins tonight, many think the Wildcats would be in.
That graph speaks to parity. youth, and for example, UConn's case, early entry to the NBA, and Bradley with O'Brien turning pro, complacency down at LSU.
Rebound by Adrian, and he got fouled as he put it in.
But Coach Calhoun took him out before. He gave him the what for, and Adrian gave himself the message as well. That was a man's rebound right there. Doesn't have lift, but he does have girth and tremendous strength. Collegiately, sometimes wide bodies are better, and you can outstrength the four position on the college level.
Adrian, a sophomore from Brookline, Mass, gives Connecticut its first field goal in 6 minutes, and he hits the free throw. 13 points, 9 rebounds for Adrian, who's two boards away from his 15th double-double.
Well, they extend man-to-man pickup point. Let's see what Dyson can do with Scotty Reynolds. It's such a luxury to have your two-guard be able to bring it like Nardi.
Reynolds looking for another three. Spins out, Johnson the rebound. Good possession here for UConn. Trying to get within six. A lot of time left. Dyson for three. UConn within five. Only the second made shot by Dyson today, but it's a big one, and it forces Villanova to call for time.
They put Redding in for defense. Jay makes a defensive substitution here.
Two timeouts remaining for Nova, one for UConn.
Connecticut pushes out on the break, passes up ahead. Dyson gathers, he's out of at least the international three. But he, like his freshman counterpart Reynolds, is green-lighted and in fact is their best shooter.
Dyson just 2 of 10 today, 2 of 8 from three. But a big shot there. Connecticut, despite its shooting woes as a team in all phases, only down 5.
And just think, Villanova's done this all year with a de facto center, Bump Sheridan, now on the bench with 5 fouls.
Reynolds with 33 points, but had a couple of fouls and a couple of missed shots the last few times down the floor. Sumter is back out there for Villanova, playing with 4 fouls.
See if Dyson can bring the eye of the Tiger to Reynolds. They switch on that pick.
Sumter, great reverse, score it. And a foul on Connecticut.
The recognition of the mismatch there on the switch, you can see Sumter take the little guy right to the block. There you see he's got the small on him. They had made a switch, and now he utilizes the rim. He's well aware he doesn't think that Habib's in the game and uses the rim to screen out the eventual shot block of Habib. That was a senior move from a fifth-year guy who was indeed a student of the game.
And a crowd killer here at Gamble. And he hits the free throw. Sumter with 13 points. Villanova back up 8. Answering the three-point shot on the other end.
You had a concern about the foul trouble, but the zone, and it's a retreated zone, I might add. They're almost defying anyone but Dyson to take that shot.
Austrie way off from 3.
And then Reynolds gets called for his 4th foul. 4 fouls on Reynolds. What do you do if you're Jay Wright, coach?
Well, first of all, I'd admonish Reynolds. He's got to know how critical he is to the game and must be made aware of the fact, look, son, you've got 3. We're green-lighting you. You are our guy. You know, you're having the night of your career. Do not, under any circumstances, get that. Then after I admonish him, I'm going to make sure to tell him, under no circumstances, step aside. You might want to go back to man-to-man with his 4 fouls and put him on Austria, challenge perimeter shooter.
Jay Wright is saying to John Cal that he didn't want a timeout. That leaves the Wildcats with 1. Reynolds appears that he's going to stay in the game. You saw the list of the players in foul trouble. Sheridan is already out. Reynolds with 33 points, but now 4 fouls.
Now you take a look at him coming off that pick, and it's been in that spot all night. And then they leave the ball, Connecticut, as we had talked about earlier. There he went through a shift of gears 3 times. Turns that corner again, but comes underneath the rim. And on both these, he comes underneath the rim, well aware that the nation's leading shot blocker, Habib, is on the court to beat, and he can't block, and he puts his hand in the cylinder, so he uses the rim as a shield.
The freshman scoring record at Villanova is 35 points. The Big East scoring record by freshman, 41, as we showed you earlier. Reynolds with 33, and going to stay on the floor. 6:16 to go. Four personal fouls for Reynolds. Alex Bradley has the Villanova scoring record. And we thought at one point, be no question that Reynolds would break it. Here Reynolds diving in there dangerously, trying to get to the loose ball, and we're going to have a Connecticut foul. And that's four on Dyson.
He called Dyson for a pile on there, I guess. I don't want to...
You got foul number 11, Jerome Dyson.
You got to love when a guy scoring 36 is the first guy to the floor for the long rebound.
And plus, you never know. You might get called for a foul in that situation when you're diving at a guy's feet, but he got to the ball first, and they got Dyson for the foul. Four on him. He's the first Connecticut player in foul trouble. Reynolds, 5 of 7 at the line tonight, shooting a 1-1. That's the 17 foul on UConn.
There's been no vibe to the game. The crowd's been a little bit out of it. The referees have called a lot of fouls.
Reynolds missed the second one. He's missed three tonight. He had missed only one in his last six games entering this game. Price, nice pass, and Atrain able to finish. Connecticut within 7 at the 6-minute mark. And another timeout called by Villanova. And they're going to be out of timeouts. Actually, they have one left. So they do have one timeout remaining, 6 minutes remaining in the contest. Big East tournament starts Wednesday, and if the Aeropostale Big East championship began today, Villanova would be a 9 seed playing DePaul. The top 4 teams get a bye in the first round. Connecticut would have Marquette in the opening round.
It's going to be some terrific contest, but getting back to here, Villanova with one timeout left and 4 fouls on Scotty Reynolds. And where is Reynolds most likely to pick up his 5th foul? In all probability, charging, getting a charging call as he takes it to the basket. He's going to have to be very astute and be aware that he must look for his middle game, his pull-up game, which isn't his style.
The one win for Villanova at Gamble was back in 1995, and UConn was number 1 at that time. Villanova blew him out. Reynolds now on the bench with those 4 fouls. He's been called for an offensive foul already in this half.
Nardi had played point guard in high school and does handle the ball.
And he goes for 3. Big shot by Nardi. Another senior coming up big on the road.
So confident and such a great shooter, but again, no help by UConn to the pick.
And Jay Wright made the point today that Scotty Reynolds is the only player on the team who has not played at Gamble. Reynolds has had the best night, 34 points, but Nardi with a big shot there, giving him 10. Sumter steps in front of Atrain, and if he calls timeout, now he wasn't able to call timeout. A new rule this year that if your momentum is carrying you out of bounds while you're in the air, you cannot call timeout. So it goes to Connecticut.
I think Sumter had the awareness of not calling timeout too. You didn't see any kind of motion for him to make that call.
That would have been the final timeout for Villanova, so I'm sure Jay Wright didn't want him to call time. Sumter again with 4 fouls, so he's going to go to the bench for a bit. Let's see how Villanova does with its top 2 scorers, Sumter and Reynolds on the bench. Nova leading by 10.
This young guy with the ball, Dyson, also has 4.
Ostry for 3. 2nd 3 tonight for Craig Ostry. Connecticut back within 7 at the 5-minute mark.
Nardi just looked over to the coach and called his own play. They're going to spread the floor and run some clock here, and probably give it down to Nardi with short seconds left on the clock. It's exactly what they're going to do. They're just running clock here. Television timeout is coming up on 4.
Shot clock inside of 10. Nardi finds Drummond. Great block by Atrain, and Ostry has it for UConn. Oh, Connecticut with 10 blocks tonight. The Huskies lead the nation in block shots. Dangerous pass by Price. Lucky that he got it back. Finds Adrian. Can't finish, but a foul on Villanova. Second foul on Clark. Two free throws coming up for Adrian. Villanova leading by 7, 4:20 on the clock in the second half here at Gamble Pavilion in Storrs. A win for Villanova ensures the Wildcats of at worst a 500 finish in the Big East Conference, and many think that with a win tonight, Villanova would secure an NCAA tournament berth. The Wildcats play Syracuse on Saturday at home.
Non-conference schedule, strength of schedule, road games, wins on the road, all of the factors that compile your RPI point to Villanova going.
And if Connecticut should come back and win this game, the Huskies would go to 7-8 in the Big East. 17-11 right now is their overall mark. Many think UConn's playing for the NIT unless they make a deep run in the Big East tournament or obviously win the Big East tournament. Adrian gets both free throws at 63-58 Villanova, 4:20 remaining. And the crowd on its feet here at Gamble Pavilion, where Connecticut has lost only 16 times ever. One of those against Villanova some 10 years ago. Sumter's three. Rebound Clark. He couldn't hang on to it, though. And a foul is called on Clark, his third. Connecticut will shoot two the rest of the way.
They got the right guy to shot there. That's all you can ask for.
Don't forget, coming up next here on ESPN, ACC Wednesday presented by Staples. The two hottest teams in the ACC, Maryland and Duke, squaring off at 9:10 Eastern time. Maryland's won a handful in a row, Duke four in a row. Dyson gets the first one. Connecticut back within four. Scotty Reynolds is back out there for Villanova with four personal fouls, 34 points for Reynolds.
Reynolds is not showing much of a middle game. If I were them, I'd bait him into driving to the rim and stand the guy, have a guy rotate in there looking to take the charge.
And again, Connecticut's free throw problems just killing them. They're 18 of 34 at the foul line. And they're only down 4 points. Ostry is on Reynolds.
Doesn't run away from the ball. He goes and gets it like a star should.
Reynolds trying to split the double team. Gets down the lane again. And a foul is called on UConn. Man, how many times has Reynolds gotten into the lane?
You've got to step out and show him that pick and roll. But I'll tell you what, you can't fault Reynolds because he's astute. He's got the change of pace. And he's fearless in going to the rim. And
here it's a 4-point game, Scott. Villanova leading 63-59. Scotty Reynolds.
Well, he gets to his spot, his shot. He drives the lane there. We said he doesn't have a middle game. Here's Adrian. He should have stepped up there and been alerted. He has four fouls and let him take the charge. He does not get to the paint and find very well. He's a score-oriented point guard, totally green-lighted, and has serious confidence.
This is the sixth time that Reynolds has had at least 9 free throw attempts. Does a great job getting into the paint. He's 8 of 11 tonight, 36 points now in the game for Reynolds. So go to the bench with those four fouls. Probably for just another short time frame. Nova's up 6.
They're going to try to play him offense, defensive possession ball here with Reynolds. They'll give him a little bit of a rest here, see if they can't. If that lead closes to 2 or 3, he'll be in.
Adrian fouled by Cunningham, and he's gone. Sheridan's already fouled out. Cunningham just fouled out. Sumter and Reynolds both have 4. Dyson, the only Connecticut player in foul trouble with 4.
Now, Jay Wright's using the foul out as an opportunity to get a free timeout call to try to set something here in terms of defense.
Only one timeout remaining for Villanova in the game. Throwdown Thursday presented by IBM tomorrow. 2 ACC games, 7 Eastern on ESPN. Virginia Tech, Virginia, followed by North Carolina, Georgia Tech on ESPN2 at 9 Eastern time. Virginia Tech, Virginia, Carolina still alive for the ACC regular season crown. Don't forget Duke and Maryland coming up next here on ESPN. Tip-off scheduled for 9:10. Jeff Adrian at the line shooting two. It's been a woeful performance for Connecticut at the foul line. 18 of 34 as a team.
They're abysmal foul shooters, and it's infectious.
And that's doubly bad when the team on the other side is second in the country in free throw shooting in Villanova at 78%. Although the Wildcats have struggled by their standard tonight at 72%.
Their best foul shooter, Reynolds, has missed three, coming in at 83%.
Reynolds back on the floor, by the way, with four fouls. One out of two for Adrian, 5-point Villanova lead.
We have talked about how they'll rotate him offense, defense. He's on offense now, but he is a charge waiting to happen if you step in on him.
Villanova fighting for its NCAA tournament lives. Trying to win on the road, and Nardi falls down. Ostry dives in there. Connecticut got possession, and then Dyson called a timeout. Great hustle by Jerome Dyson.
With four fouls himself, he showed a lot of courage, heart, and then smarts. Connecticut had it. Look at him level off that with Nardi. Pounces on it like the football player he used to be. Pulls it out of the scrum. There you see it again. There's Nardi. He's so frustrated in himself. He has such good body language in terms of being a teammate, and now he's down himself. I hope someone's over there picking him up. I like that kid's competitive spirit and unselfishness.
Villanova trying to get its 20th win. If the Wildcats do so, that would make eight Big East teams with 20 wins, and that's actually more than they had last year going into the Big East tournament. They got eight teams in the NCAA tournament last year, and Joe Lenardi in his updated bracketology has eight in this year. We'll see.
They're in the zone. The beat should get down there and get ready to get a foot back.
Adrian banks it in nicely. 20 points now for Adrian.
Jim did a good job out of that timeout, getting the shot he wanted for the player he wanted in the situation he wanted to get it.
And then another bad play by Nardi, just turning it over, and then Dyson driving in gets fouled. Back-to-back turnovers by Nardi in Connecticut within three. Here's the tournament resume for Villanova. Some good wins out of conference, good wins in conference, and get the schedule strength and RPI that are pretty good too.
They've got the Joe Lenardi, our bracketologist numbers, but there's almost an exclamation point you need to finish 8-8 in the league, but nevertheless, right here, Nardi's playing the game backward a bit, frustrated himself for losing the ball the last time against Dyson, then tries to throw the home run pass.
One more free throw coming up for Dyson, coming up on ESPN following this game here, Duke and Maryland. ACC Wednesday presented by Staples. Dyson missed the second one. Thabeet with a rebound, and Connecticut can take the lead. Ostry missed the three, but Thabeet is there. And he's fouled, and will go to the line for two.
This is the best I've seen Thabeet in terms of rebounding, not bringing the ball down, aggressiveness to the rim. He's got bounce. He gets off quickly off of both feet. Keeps it alive. Thabeet kicks it out. Rebounds that one and takes it up.
Did it not look like Connecticut was dead in the water about 5 minutes ago?
That technical foul, which was inadvertent, that was not a calculated technical by Jim, got the crowd back in. The players, it stirred their emotions. And the realization may have set in what's on the line. Here they're just circumventing the rule. They're trying to get that extra timeout called. Noble over there with only one timeout. When I say the extra timeout, they're using the mandatory 30 seconds that you had to put the sub in to try to get a little bit of a team huddle going.
Don't forget Reynolds picked up his fourth foul about that time as well, that Calhoun got that technical a few minutes after it. Thabeet struggles at the free throw line, and that's a trend that's continuing tonight. Had been pretty good the last five games, over 70%, but just 2 for 6 in this game.
He puts his thumb on the ball, the flat of his thumb's on the ball. The ball has no rotation to it. His hands are so big, it's always difficult for a big-handed guy, see Shaq, to shoot the three throw, Wilt Chamberlain. And believe me, he's every bit. He's taller than Wilt, probably. He's legit 7'3".
One out of two for Thabeet. Connecticut within a point. An 11-2 run by the Huskies. Clark gets it across to Nardi. Nardi's turned it over the last couple of times. He's been the lead guard. Reynolds can't get the ball. Good defense by Oster.
He might want to drive. Nardi might want to look to drive Dyson with the four fouls on him. They can ill afford to lose their best shooter and go to score.
Reynolds for three. In and out. Oh, Sumter is there, and he sticks it back in.
Oh, was that a senior captain leadership rebound? Road tested and tough, Curtis Sumter. The man they left behind, Lowry, Foy, Allen.
Having a great year after the knee injuries that cost him last season.
Look at this rebound and look at that putback. Gathered himself, went up off of 2 feet.
15 points in the game. Remember, he's playing with four fouls as well.
So hard to get elevation with 2 torn ACLs and without a step.
Dyson gets into the lane. And Nardi with a rebound. Villanova ball and a 3-point lead, 90 seconds remaining.
Looking all for himself here. Here comes the pick. It's going to come on that wing area. It's been in that spot all night.
Reynolds driving. Off the hands of Drummond. Reynolds got it back. Going to take it in on Thabeet. Great move by the freshman, Scotty Reynolds.
He baited him. Thabeet came, and he used the rim in order to negate the shot-blocking ability of Thabeet.
And even Larry Brown likes that move. Ostry's three, air ball, rebound Drummond, and Scotty Reynolds, who has 38 points with the ball, and he's fouled by Ostry.
And he got that foul too. This kid has a real presence of mind and is so smart.
What an incredible night for Scotty Reynolds.
Take a look at Reynolds right here. He's gonna come, takes it away from the screen, uses the rim, double clutches. And that double clutch degree of difficulty shot was necessitated by the defense. There's the beat. He's left standing in his tracks simply because you cannot impede the progress of the ball off the backboard with your hand in the rim.
But Reynolds missed the free throw. And they're going to give the ball to Villanova. Wow, it looked like Drummond committed a foul. But instead, it's going to be Wildcat ball. 49.9 on the clock. Scotty Reynolds already has the freshman record at Villanova for scoring in a game. 41 points is the Big East record. Marco Locar back in 1990 for Seton Hall did it against Pitt. And Reynolds will go to the line and shoot two, as that's Connecticut's 10th team foul.
They had to foul irrespective of who had the ball, and Nova did a nice job of getting to the man they want on the line.
9 out of 13 tonight at the stripe for Scotty Reynolds.
The Nova fans behind their bench can sense victory, and the UConn fans have headed for the exits.
A Villanova win secures at worst a 500 mark in the league and likely a berth in the NCAA tournament. And then a blocking foul is called on Reynolds, and he just fouled out with 41 seconds left. So not only do they lose the leading scorer in the game with 40 points, but their best free throw shooter.
He and Dyson each had four. He should have known better than to try to put himself in a situation where the referee had to make a decision. But then again, he's only a freshman. Sometimes, because his point and his talent are so great, our expectation is that he plays like a veteran.
And those 40 points, the most by a visiting player at Gamble Pavilion. The prior high, Lindsey Hunter with 38 points, Jackson State back in 1983. Villanova by 7, 40.8 on the clock. And Dice into the line, shooting two free throws. Duke and Maryland underway. We'll bring it to you. ACC Wednesday presented by Staples, and we're done here in stores.
Well, the assumption is you go down 6 here. You either want to use a freelance center field press with the inbounder, or you want to play a man-to-man, and then you want to go for one trap, and that gives you 4 opportunities to get the ball.
Dyson missed the second one. Rebound by Drummond. Connecticut shooting right around 50% at the free throw line today. And Drummond, who on the year is 4 of 11 at the free throw line, will shoot 2. Still a chance for Connecticut. A lot of time left, and Drummond not a good foul shooter at the line. And again, Scotty Reynolds fouled out with 40 points. Each team with a 1 timeout left.
They had to foul whomever. It was fortuitous for him that Drummond got the rebound.
Missed them both. Here comes UConn. Austrey on the drive, got fouled by Nardi. That's not what you want if you're Villanova.
No, you want to run away from the foul. You don't want to stop the clock. 6-point lead, 3 possession game.
That's 4 on Nardi. Three players have already fouled out for the Wildcats: Reynolds, Sheridan, and Cunningham. Sumter and Nardi, the other 2 starters for the Wildcats, both have 4. Austrey shooting his first free throw of the night. He's a 74% foul shooter. UConn 23 of 43 at the line tonight.
And Nova has its best 5 foul shooters in the game now. Fully anticipating that they're going to be AB pressed, come to meet the ball, create space, be strong with it. They're going to have to foul you, double you, and then foul the next pass.
Redding will inbound, 4-point game. That's the guy you want on the line of the players remaining in the game if you're Villanova. Nardi's an 86% free throw shooter and 4 for 4 tonight.
And oh so confident.
Third foul on Kelly. Third foul on Curtis Kelly.
It's like putting in golf. It involves the 2 greatest dichotomies, relaxation and concentration, foul shooting. You can't aim it, or you'll short stroke it.
Got the first one to go. Maryland and Duke are underway. We'll get you right out to Mike Patrick, Dick Vitale, Doris Burke. Coming up next, ACC Wednesday presented by Staples. Villanova 32 seconds away from perhaps sealing a bid in the NCAA tournament. They play Syracuse at home on Saturday to wrap up the regular season. The Big East tournament next week in New York. Dyson missing, but he tips it home. Back to a 4-point game. Timeout, Connecticut. And that's the last timeout of the game for UConn. 1 remaining for Villanova. Let's go back to the studio, check in with Scott Reese.
Okay, Dave, as you mentioned, Duke and Maryland underway, and it looks like it's going to be a whale of a ball game. Maryland got the early lead, but DeMarcus Nelson leading the Dukies right back with a triple. It is now 15-12, and of course, we'll send you out to that game as soon as we're done in stores, as both teams riding win streaks. Maryland 5 in a row, Duke 4 in a row. Again, we'll send you out there as soon as your game is over, Dave.
Scott here, Villanova's ball with a 4-point lead. And coach, if you're Connecticut, when you get the ball back with 26 seconds left, still time for 2, or are you thinking 3 at this point?
No, my rule on there is I'm looking for a 2. If I fall into a 3, I take it. And then I've got to have my defense set. I've got to know who I want to foul. Mostly I want to make sure that they don't inbound the ball to Nardi easily. I might want to take a guy off the inbounder and play him in front and back and sandwich Nardi, because he's a senior, he's veteran, and he's an 83% foul shooter. Make somebody else get it.
3 players have already fouled out for Villanova, including Scotty Reynolds, who had 40 points tonight, the most ever by a visitor here at Gamble Pavilion. Reggie Redding will inbound.
And they'll give Nardi plenty of space. I like the way they're spreading the floor. Watch him move to get this catch.
They can't get it into Nardi. Sumpter's a pretty good free throw shooter. He's fouled. Sumpter shoots 82% from the line. And it's one for one in this game.
You want to go percentage and you want to go veteran. They did the two things you want to go with.
Well, Sumpter had a huge play a few minutes ago when Connecticut had cut it to a two-point game, and then Sumpter got a big rebound inside and stuck it back in. 15 points, 10 rebounds for the senior from Brooklyn. It is not over yet.
UConn out of timeouts, as well as Villanova, of course.
Wildcats with one timeout remaining as Sumpter gets the second one. 5-point game. Price off the screen. Here's Dyson for three. In and out. Great rebound by Kelly. And it's a one possession game with 15 seconds left. They're able to get it in bounds to Nardi. They didn't foul him. What was Connecticut doing in the backcourt? Austria had Redding, who's only a 59% free throw shooter, and he let him get away.
They needed to foul immediately. They trapped Nardi. Anyone he throws to, even Sheridan, with that time short, you got to know the seconds on the clock.
And now Shane Clark, who in the last 5 minutes this year is shooting 89% at the free throw line, will go to the stripe. And plus, that cost you time off the clock. You probably only have one more crack at it if you're Connecticut. Whereas if you foul with 10 seconds left, you probably still have two chances. And that may have just sealed it for Villanova. Scotty Reynolds, the story tonight for the Wildcats, with 40 points. Great night for the freshman. Trying to impress the NCAA tournament committee. Certainly did that. Villanova by five. Three from Dyson. Good with 1.3 on the clock. 2-point game.
Just get it in and hold it.
Redding got it into Sumpter. They foul him with 0.4 seconds left. And you go back to those seconds that Villanova, or Connecticut rather, wasted by not fouling in the backcourt when they had a chance to get Reggie Redding.
Got to always remember this on a bad team. Somebody's got to score. And also, when you're down and you think that the game's over with and you mount that comeback, it's always free and easy. All of a sudden, when it gets down very close, then you start measuring your shot psychologically.
If Sumpter makes the second one, it's over. If he misses it, UConn's going to need a full court shot to tie it.
Connecticut never quit. They courted themselves well.
Sumpter gets them both. Dyson at the buzzer. And Villanova wins. The Wildcats, behind Scotty Reynolds, 40 points, beat Connecticut 78-74. For Rick Majerus, I'm Dave Pasch, saying so long from Storrs. Time now for Duke and Maryland. Here's Mike Patrick. Mike.